Hello everyone, welcome to the Sidekick View. This is your sidekick Hitesh and today we are going to review Judgmental Hai Kya, starring Kangana Ranaut, Rajkumar Rao. It's been directed by Prakash Kovelamudi and it's been written by Kanika Dhillon. So let's jump into the Sidekick View of Judgmental Hai Kya. So the movie starts with Kangana Ranaut as a kid and it's shown that her mother is a victim of domestic violence and a few incidents happen and it's shown that both of her mother and father die, and because of the disturbed childhood she grows up to be a bit abnormal. Cut to and we move 20 years ahead when she is an adult now and she has been shown as a dubbing artist, and the problem with Kangana Ranaut is whichever character she plays while dubbing, she tries to enact the same when she is in real life. So if she's a cop, she'll try to be a cop. If she's a villain, she'll try to be a villain. And enters Rajkumar Rao with his wife as her tenants. And stuff happen and there is a murder. And then you think, so it's gonna be a murder mystery and who did it and who not. But the movie never goes there. But the whole murder thing is shown very casually. And the police very casually close the case, and we do not till the end we do not try find who the actual murderer is. In fact, I thought it would turn out to be similar to Badla, where you are trying to figure out who actually killed it. We do try to figure it out, but it is in such a vague way that you lose your complete interest in the movie. But we move to London in the second half, and again a similar trajectory happens, wherein Kangana again meets Rajkumar and similar stuff starts happening. Throughout the movie, we think that now it's gonna change, because throughout the movie you keep on thinking that okay, now there is gonna be a real twist which is gonna shock you, but no such thing happens. The background score throughout the movie tries to tell you, okay, now you need to be afraid, now you need to be excited, now you need to be thrilled, but nothing of this sort happens, because on screen there is nothing of this sort which is happening. Kangana and Rajkumar have tried to put a good show, but the lackluster script doesn't help them at all, and the supporting actors are pathetic. Even someone like Satish Kaushik has been used very vaguely, and I don't know why Jimmy Shergill even signed for this film. He has nothing to do in the movie. Moving on to the direction feels very vague, and you can see throughout the movie that the director has very less hold over what is going around. So for example, there is a scene in second half wherein Rajkumar Rao tries to call Kangana Ranaut sex, and he asks him to gather some proof against Kangana Ranaut. So in the first half, there has been no plot which shows that these two characters are good friends. I think so the director thinks that the audience is a fool. He just picks up his phone, calls Kangana Ranaut's ex, who he doesn't know at all, via a video call, and they are talking with each other as in they are friends forever. Again, the person that he calls very easily goes into Kangana's house, gets all the proof and sends it to Rajkumar Rao. So we know that Kangana is shown mentally challenged in the movie, but you don't go to London without locking your house. So he very easy. So things, small things like this can make you very irritated. The director should know that we have all seen CID and Crime Patrol all our lives. So we know that how a crime gets investigated, how the police work. So the director is just trying to fool you, and you don't get fooled. That's why the movie is a big no for me. So the last thing I'd like to tell you about this movie is the portrayal of people who may be a little mentally challenged is very wrong. They try to put a disclaimer at the beginning of the movie, but that does not help. You could get away with such portrayals in a comedy movie, but in such a movie, which I am still trying to figure out whether it was a drama or thriller or a crime mystery, you cannot portray them this way. It's a very vague portrayal of such people, and in a society like us, it does not help a lot, wherein people still feel mental health as a taboo. So it is not a good job from the director or the producers of the movie. And again, the verdict is a big no. please try to save your money and don't go for judgmental like, yeah, if you want, The Lion King is still running in the movies, and if you are still not wanting to watch that, Super 30, Kangana Ranaut ki favorite Hrithik ka bhi movie chal raha hai, so you could either watch that. If you have enjoyed the video, please subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and do keep smiling and keep your sidekicks happy. Thank you.